Hey Luke, tell us a bit more then about what Liz Truss had to say and what her vision now is for the UK.
Well, it's the same kind of story as we've seen with the campaign for the leadership of the Tory party and indeed ultimately Prime Minister. And the same kind of thing in the speech that we have now heard. Long on promise and kind of light on substance. Neither candidate really ever said that what they were going to do. Liz Truss speaking of tax cuts, but no specifics, something that we are going to expect to be now hearing in the days and weeks ahead. She obviously has a massive inbox to get to grips with. She is coming in at a time of the highest inflation in the UK in 40 years. She's coming in off the back of COVID. She's coming in still dealing with the economic damage from Brexit. And she's coming in at the time of the worst cost of living crisis in memory. Now, she's going to need to prove that not only can she handle that, but she can handle the Conservative Party as well. She's going to need to unite it. She's seen very much as almost a continuation of Boris Johnson, proving her loyalty to him. She stayed by his side as he was deserted before he stepped down. So she is going to need to try to do what she can to unite the Tory party and indeed tackle the situation with the cost of living crisis moving forward.
And Luke, what happens in the next 48 hours now?
Well, ultimately, Boris Johnson will be leaving Downing Street for the last time. He will be heading to Scotland on the Tuesday. He will be handing his resignation into the Queen, after which the Liz Truss will see the monarch as well, and she will be asked to form a government. After that, she will be coming back down to London to get to grips with the situation as things stand here.
Luke Schrago, outside Downing Street. Thanks very much indeed.